Over time, your knife is going to become dull just with regular use. Doesn't matter if it's cheap or expensive, what it's made out of. It's just a natural part of daily use. If it's ever very difficult to cut down on something and you're using a lot of pressure, it's a telltale sign that your knife is very dull. Dull knives can be difficult to work with, not to mention dangerous. With a dull knife, you're much more likely to hurt yourself. You're having to exert a lot more force. You're much more likely to slip and cut yourself. It's just really not worth it. So here are a few ways to keep your knives sharp and in good shape. So this is a honing steel. It's a common misconception that it sharpens your knife. It actually just hones the edge. Steel is softer than you think it is. So when you're chopping down, it's just naturally gonna bend it a little bit. And so what this is gonna do is just kind of straighten it back out again. It's not gonna take off any of the steel. It's not gonna sharpen it, but it's going to just help it be a little bit straighter until you're able to sharpen it again. They're pretty heavy. This little guard here will protect you from accidentally getting your finger. You know, you see chefs on TV like doing it really cool up in the air, but actually if you just put this little tip down on the tabletop or on a cloth or something just for a little stability, it's much easier to get a good angle. So whether you're honing or sharpening, we're always looking for roughly a 20 degree angle. And that can be a little bit difficult to imagine just kind of putting your knife up to the steel. So it's easier for the eye to work in halves. So you can start at 90, cut that in half to 45, cut that in half again, and that's gonna be 22.5, which is, you know, roughly where you wanna be. And what you're trying to do here is go from the heel of the knife, the very back of it, all the way to the front with a very consistent pressure on both sides the whole time. And you have to go back and forth to ensure that you're really aligning both sides of the knife. And this is a great way for when you're just starting to learn how to hone your knife, to make sure you're getting a good angle and doing it properly before you move on to looking like a cool chef and doing it in the air. Just make sure that you're always maintaining that 20 degree angle. And honing is great for maintenance because it will maintain a sharper edge for a little bit longer. It'll also make it easier when it does come time to sharpen your knife because it's not as out of whack as it would be. You only need to do it a few times back and forth, really. Again, you're just kind of realigning that edge, so it doesn't matter how many times you do this, it's not gonna sharpen your knife. To sharpen your knife, you're gonna need a tool that will take off a little bit of the steel. This is like a very basic version of a knife sharpener. As you can see, we have the coarse side and the fine side. You're gonna start on the coarse side and then you're gonna work your way down to the fine side. And what you're gonna do is put it on a stable surface and put the knife in that little divot and you're gonna pull the knife back towards you using a firm and even pressure the entire time, going from the heel to the tip. The biggest thing you wanna be careful of is keeping your knife straight up and down. If you go and kind of wobble from one side to the other, you're just gonna unevenly sharpen your knife. And you just need to do a few swipes on the coarse side and then work your way down to the fine side. And again, only a few swipes there and you should be good. This is a great maintenance tool. It's very simple and easy to use for beginners. But if you really have a very damaged knife or you need a very sharp edge, the next kind of step up would be using a whetstone. And just like the other tool, you have a coarse side and a fine side. Again, you're gonna wanna start on the coarse side. First things first, we have to get it wet. So you just wanna soak it pretty much until all the little bubbles just disappear and it's completely saturated with water. And just like with the honing steel, how we were trying to get a 20 degree angle, we're gonna want a 20 degree angle with the whetstone as well. Another trick to help you visualize what 20 degrees should look like is folding a piece of paper diagonally. Because we know this corner is a 90 degree angle, we're gonna use that as a reference point. Fold in half on a diagonal to get us 45 degrees. Fold that in half again to give us 22.5, which is roughly where we wanna be. You can lay that piece of paper flat side down on your whetstone, lay your knife on top of that, and that's gonna be your guide for what angle our knife should be at. So what you wanna do is drag the heel of your knife down and press the knife down into the whetstone from the heel all the way to the tip in kind of a gliding motion, going back and forth, one side, then the other side. The biggest thing you wanna worry about here is making sure that you're keeping that 20 degree angle and also you're keeping a very even pressure throughout. You also don't want your whetstone to get too dry, so if you notice it's kind of drying out or it's making a really crazy sound, just sprinkle some more water on the whetstone. If it's just for a little bit of maintenance, you should only have to do this a few times on each side before you move on to the fine side. But if you have a really damaged knife, you might have to do this quite a few times in order to shave off enough of the steel to get a sharp blade again. And once you feel like you've gotten your knife pretty sharp, you can do the tomato test. And what you want to do here is test each part of the blade to make sure that you evenly sharpened your knife. And if there is a little dull spot, you can just go back to the whetstone. You're going to still do that same sweeping motion you did before, but you're just going to take extra care on the section of the knife that was a little bit duller, making sure that you're pressing down evenly on that part as well. Now that your knife is sharp, here are a few tips on ways to keep it sharper for longer. First things first, don't put it in the dishwasher. Things kind of bang around in there. It's just, you're not really as careful when you're kind of throwing things in there. Just carefully hand wash it and then just give it a quick dry after you're done to prevent it from rusting. There's a lot of cool things out there now for storing your knife. If you don't have a lot of storage, these little knife sleeves are great. If you're gonna be storing your knives in a drawer, definitely get a knife sleeve. It's gonna protect the knife's edge as well as your hands if you're ever reaching in there. There's also a variety of knife blocks that will safely store the knives and prevent them from knocking around in a drawer. And you just wanna be careful that you're not pressing the blade down on the wood as you go. And then last thing, if you're gonna have a knife block like this when you're sliding them in, you wanna carefully slide the back of the knife into the slot, just ensuring that you're not pressing the blade on the block itself. Also making sure that your knife isn't too tall for the slot so that the tip of the knife isn't hitting the bottom of the slot. You just want to protect the blade. You don't want it to hit the knife block. And that way your knives will be sharper for longer. The more you do this, the less daunting it's going to feel. Ideally, you're honing your knife before you use it every single time. For maintenance, you can sharpen your knife every few months or whenever you feel like they're getting dull. It's not a bad idea to get your knife sharpened by a professional every 6 months or a year as well, but these are great skills that you can do at home for regular maintenance. You only need to do it a few times back and forth, really.
Unless your daughter's boyfriend's coming over and you want to sharpen your knives right in front of him. No, I'm just being an idiot.
Okay,